Hello, good afternoon, students. Join the class now. And in past some lectures, we have discussed about MCQ type of questions, which is a part of this examination. So we will be discussing that. And in today's lecture, we will be discussing about word formation. I have given all the MCQ type of questions related with the all four units, and that we will have to prepare it for coming CAT examination also. And at the same time, we can prepare the same MCQ type of question bank which I had given to you in previous lecture in the past, that you will have to prepare for your final examination also. So everybody has to prepare it properly. It is very essential. Don't take it lightly. Join the class immediately. After 2 minutes, I can start my lecture. This was the particular word formation process was left that I wanted to complete earlier. It would be due to MCQ question banks. MCQ question bank. I covered up that first portion, and now there is a chance that we can interact and we can discuss about word formation process. So let's begin. Word formation unit number 2. We all are very curious about how new words are formed. And in this chapter, we will be discussing about how new words are formed. This particular question comes for 1 or 2 marks in university paper, and because this university is conducting MCQ questions, MCQ type of questions. So it will be natural that such kind of questions will ask. They will ask the category about the particular word formation process, and you will have to find out the correct answer in that. So let's begin. How new words are being formed in the language that we will have discussed. Word formation is a great interest for linguistics as it sheds light on other aspects of language. Entry of a word in a language. The first process that begin to form the new words in English language, that is called etymology. That is called etymology. It is the studies of the history of words, their origin, and how their form and meaning change over time. English word formation having different formation process. There are 12 particular word formation process that we will be discussing in today's lecture that you will have to understand. And most importantly, that there are some popular word formation process like derivation, like acronym, like compounding, like borrowing, blending, and clipping. These are the very popular word formation process that are asked in several examination, including GATE exam also. So you need to understand about this. This is very important. One after another, we will be discussing. Okay, by the time you will have to understand this. Okay, the first word formation process called coinage. Second is borrowing. Third is fall. Fourth is compound. Fifth is derivation. Sixth is blending. Seventh is back formation. Eighth is conversion. Ninth is acronym. Tenth is initialism. 11 is onomatopoeia, and 12 is clipping. The first part is coinage, the word formation process of inventing entirely new words called coinage. Like example, with the following example, we will understand about the process of coinage. This is the first word formation process. The examples are robotics, that included in 1941, genocide, that is in 1943, black hole, 1968, blog, internet, Google, aspirin, search words are called are just got the entry in English language through this process. We need to understand properly. For that, we need to discuss more examples. The first example is e-recruitment. Online, that means online recruitment of employees, online submission of resumes and cover letters. Next is netbook, small laptop computer which weighs less than 3 pounds and has a 7 to 10 inch screen. Not spot, an area where there is a low internet access or no connection at all. Slumdog, very poor, underprivileged person who lives in an overcrowded slum. That movie, I think you might have seen, Slumdog Millionaire. That means very poor, underprivileged person who lives in an overcrowded slum. Next word from formation process is eponym. That means new words based on names of person or place. See, listen, I again explain the same content that you should understand. Eponym is the next word forming process. What happened in this process? New words based on names of person or place. For example, world, Alessandro, Volta, Italian words. Watt, because of James Watt, Scott, scientist. Boycott, Charles Boycott, who was Irish. Fahrenheit, Jebrail Fahrenheit, who was German scientist. This process, because these new words are formed, because of it is based on names of persons or place. So James Watt, he was a famous scientist, and because of that, we use that particular, whenever we have to map this particular power, energy power, we consider as a watt, 6 watt, 7 watt, 10 watt, 20 watt, 15 watt, like that only. So this name got because of the person James Watt. This process of word formation called eponym. Next one, borrowing. Borrowing, that we all know, when we take something from someone else, that process called borrow. Borrowing, this is a process of actually borrowing words from foreign languages. When we take the words from foreign languages, that time, this process called borrowing. There are number of times that we have received, or number of times we have taken words from other languages, including Hindi language also. This process called borrowing. The English language has been borrowing words from nearly 100 languages in the last 100 years. Can you imagine? In the last 100 years, nearly 100 languages, we have taken words. We have taken words nearly 100 languages in the last 100 years. So you can imagine, English is not just a native language that is not limited to the particular Great Britain, England, but nowadays, because we have, nowadays means what? It has been taken since last 100 years, and more than 100 languages got entry in English language. This process called borrowing. The other way around, many countries also have taken many English words into their dictionaries, such as the well-known OK or internet. See, we are very popular among using such kind of word like OK or internet. Such time, we will have to understand these words are from, other language that you have to understand. The other way around, many countries also have taken many English words into their dictionaries, such as well-known OK and internet. This is also, these words are also borrowed from other language, other countries also. Most of the loan words are nouns, only some of them are verbs or adjective. This is also one thing that we all have to keep in mind, that most of the loan words means that we have taken from other country, other languages, that are nouns. Only some of them are verbs and adjectives. Only some of them are verbs or adjectives. In Latin, interim, memorandum, agenda, PM, and AM, sponsor. These words we have taken from Latin language. At the other hand, Greek, pneumonia, panorama, psychoanalysis, psychology, Python, these are the Greek words. From French, we have taken bureau, cafe, chauffeur, habitual, attaché, à la carte, from French. The other hand, in India, Sanskrit, chakra, mahatma, nirvana, musk, these are the words we have taken, these are the words we have borrowed from Sanskrit language, and that is included in English language. Hindi, from Hindi, our national language, these words are also, these are the following words that is also included in English language, like avatar, bungalow, jungle, pajamas, veranda, shampoo, yoga, pandit, chita, etc. Third word formation is kak, call. Direct translation in this process, direct translation of the element of word into the borrowing language. Direct translation of the element of a word into the borrowing language. Word for word translation of a word, of a phrase borrowed from another language. Example, Spanish from English. Perros calientes, dog hot, hot dog. See, perros calientes, dog hot equal to hot dog. Spanish from English. Spanish from English. Next is very popular, that is called compounding process. That is called compounding process. Compounding is the process of putting words together to build a new one that does not denote two things but one, and that is pronounced as one unit. I repeat so that you should understand. Compounding is the process of word formation. There, compounding is the process of putting words together to build a new one that doesn't denote two things but one, that is pronounced as one unit. For example, handbag. So these are the two words, hand plus bag, but we call as handbag. At the same one, second, wall plus paper, called wallpaper, that we use in a home. Fingerprint, finger plus print. Sunburn, sun plus burn. This process called compounding. What happened exactly in compounding? That is the process of putting words together to build a new one. Two words are there, we will have to form one word. That process called a compounding, that you should understand. Next is derivation. Derivation, as the most common word formation process, builds new words by adding morphemes. This is a new technique to form the new words. It is the process that is most common word formation process, and that is build new words by adding morphemes. For example, word formation by affixes. See, by prefixes, unusual, un-usual, mispronounce, mispronounce, mislead, mis plus lead, mislead, dis plus respect, disrespect. By suffix, C suffix, the suffix morphemes add at the end of the word. By suffix, care plus less, careless, child plus ish, childish, faith plus full, faithful. If you want to take the both example of prefix and suffix, disloyal, disloyalty, unerring, unerringly. Blending. A blending is a combination of two or more words to create a new one. Usually by taking the beginning of the other word and the end of the other word. This is also very interesting word for formation process that you should understand. What happened in this then? By taking the beginning of the other word and the end of the other one. There are two different words are there. We are taking first part of one word and we are taking last part of another word. So for example, the first word is brunch. It is the part of breakfast and lunch. Brunch. Breakfast is the first word and the last word is lunch. That is called brunch. Breakfast plus lunch. Second one is motel. When we have to talk about when we are visiting some place, we look for motel and hotel. So instead of that, we will be using motor plus hotel called motel. The same way, smog plus fog, smog. Transistor, transfer plus resistor. Emoticon, emotion plus icon, emoticon. The same way, nowadays due to pandemic, this word is very popular. Webinar, web plus seminar, web plus seminar. The first part is of the word is web, the other part is seminar. So if you include the both the words and form the new word, it will be webinar. Some more examples we will have to discuss of the same. Sitcom, situation plus comedy. Sitcom, television series based on humorous everyday situation. Sitcom, it is called sitcom. Remember, situation plus comedy. Netiquette, network plus etiquette. I repeat, network is the first word and the last word is etiquette. Now netiquette formed the new word. Netizen, internet plus citizen. Internet plus citizen, netizen. Pack formation. Pack formation is the process of that reduction of nouns to form new words like television. So we have to reduce of nouns to form a verbs. It's a noun and we need to form into verb. At that time, what we do, we reduce the nouns to form the verbs. Like example number one, television. And after reduction of particular noun, it will be televise. Donation, donate. Option, opt. Emotion, emote. Enthusiasm, enthuse. Editor, edit. Acronym. Acronym, word form, initial of all set of words. Nowadays, it's very important to know about the acronym process because people don't want to read a lengthiest words, lengthiest sentence. They want to shrink it. And these are the particular process called acronym. There, what happened? Word from initials of a set of words. We have to take initials from the set of words. For example, scuba. Scuba is very popular process that generally people near the sea, they get breathing under the water. This process called scuba diving. In this particular, if you see the spelling of scuba, that is S-C-U-B-A. S stand for self, C stand for contained, U stand for underwater, B stand for breathing, and A stand for apparatus. This process called self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. And the short form that we can say in other common language is to the process of acronym called SCUBA. Radar. Whenever we discuss about the news, about the national security, that time this word comes in our mind. Radar. Radar is the initial of radio detection and ranging. Radio detection and ranging. That is RA taken, D taken from detection, A taken from end, and R taken from ranging. The same way, laser, light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. LASER. And the most popular, pin. Pin number, everybody wants to know about the pin number of their area. The pin stands for personal identification number. The area, personal identification number, pin. More examples. Initialism. The next process, word formation process, is called initialism. What happened in this process? Just look at here. Initialisms are pronounced as a sequence of letters. Initialisms are pronounced as a sequence of letters. DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, C. USA, United States of America. Initialism, the initial words we have to take called initialism. These are all pronounced as a sequence of letters. Onomatopoeia. Words are difficult to pronounce, but the process is called onomatopoeia. this special type of words that depicts the sound associated with what is named, like buzz, hiss, sizzle, cuckoo, crash, bang, hush, tic-tac, etc. But the words which creates a buzz, the special type of word that depicts the sound associated with what is named, like buzz. See, if you pronounce buzz, at the same time sounds also pronounced like that only. Hiss, sizzle, cuckoo, crash, bang, hush, tic-tac. Let's move on for the next word formation process, that is called clipping. Clipping. Let's check if anyone joined or not. By the time, only two are there. As one is Ganesh Sare and one is Prathamesh Vasade. We are not getting the other students are not getting the importance of this lecture. They are not being in the class. Even next work, tomorrow onward, there will be July month. And nobody is there for getting such kind of information. What efforts we are taking? Can you see this through the slides only? We are collecting information so that you should get proper education for this. But those students, those are not in the class, I really disappointed because of their absentee. Let it be. The class will be continued. The clipping process, the next word formation process is called clipping. Shortening of a poly, I repeat, shortening of a polysyllabic word. It's types like back clipping, fore clipping, middle, and complex clipping. For example, facsimile, fax, phonetic, telephone, gasoline, influenza, table telegram, etc. Now we will be discussing about the clipping process. Shortening of a polysyllabic word. Types: back clipping, fore clipping, middle and complex clipping. These are the types of clipping. And now we will be discussing about example. Facsimile, the short form of this fax. Facsimile is the process. Phonetic, fan, telephone, phone, gasoline, gas, influenza, flu, cable telegram, cablegram, gym, lab, exam, math, and process, and professor. These are the example of clipping process, that shortening of polysyllabic word that you should know. And the types are divided into four categories, like back clipping, fore clipping, middle clipping, and complex clipping, that you should understand. Now, time to take conclusion. As we have seen before, there are many ways to create new words. So finally, if we take a look around, we will see a mass of new words surrounding us that brought us to both consciously by language trends and unconsciously through language change over time. Language changes constantly, and who knows if the people will understand the language if we are using now in a few decades. We will have some more example of compounding, like fireplace, postman, doghouse, pen holder, pickup van, pickpocket, pen dry, blackboard, art pen, bathroom, and passers-by. These are the compounding words that you should keep in. This already asked in examination. At the same way, we will have blending examples also, like brunch, breakfast, and lunch, mockumentary like mock and documentary, motel like motor and hotel that we have discussed in the previous part of this lecture. Electrocute, electric, and execute, smog, and fog. So these are the process that you all have to understand about word formation process. It is really neat for everyone because we should get out of marks here also in this functional English paper. And if you want to achieve your master's for that qualifying examination, like GATE examination, this question is asked. So you should prepare it properly, and then only it will be possible for you to get the good marks. And I would like to remind, because today is the 30th of June, today is the last day of supposed to end the particular session. If anyone has still the queries, they can ask to me personally on my WhatsApp. And I request all those who are absent, you should watch my previous videos that I have uploaded on unit number 1 to 5, MCQ question bank. I repeat, question bank, that will be integral part of your CAT 1 examination. That will be going to commence from 5th of July, or it will be also helpful for you for your university examination, because I have made all this 5 units question bank. There are more than 30 questions we have discussed in each unit. So that will be sufficient for all of you to crack this exam with a good percentage of marks. Still having queries, you may ask to me. And thank you so much for being with me, Prithamesh, Ganesh, and any other student. Thank you so much for being with me and patience listening. Thank you so much. I'm going to end my class. Thank you. We will be meeting tomorrow, inshallah.